Hey, this is DJ from DJ's Trains on YouTube, and this is part two of the cold docs video. Now in the first part, we learned how to make the foundation with the styrofoam, and then we also made the retaining wall. Now, I want to talk about the retaining wall for a second. I see a lot of these steel retaining walls, not just along the river like you see here, but I see them along like hillsides and areas where you don't want the ground to move. This is a junkyard. And it's near the tracks, and it's a great way for them to get as much space without having a hillside. So if you have a layout and you want to give it a little bit extra height or depth, and you don't want to make the hill, use one of these retaining walls. Now for my retaining wall, I wanted to have more color to it, just like in this picture. So I used three acrylic paints. I used black, brown oxide, and khaki. And these paints are only like 50 cents to a dollar at Michael's or Padcatan's or whatever. They're easy to use, no smell acrylic paints. Then I started with the brown and did the whole thing with one of these cheap 25 cent foam brushes. Got it all painted the brown color, and then I went over with the black and then with the khaki. And it looks really realistic, very easy to do. Now for the river, I didn't want that wood grain to show through or the nails. So I went over it with joint compound, just one simple layer with a joint compound I think was enough, and then I smoothed it out. Here is it before I smoothed it out with sandpaper. Once I got it all nice and smooth, I painted it, and I used my photos of the river to get like the right color that I wanted. It was kind of like a mixture of like ivy green. You'll find different acrylic paints to match the color that you're looking for. So I had it all painted green, and once that dried, then it was time to use my water method. Now I've done a video before called How to Make a River. Same technique, you want to make sure that since you don't want the water to run off, I took styrene and I duct taped it to the edge, made sure that there was no gaps, and then I took clear latex silicone, and this stuff that I'm showing here works perfect. And what you want to do is make just a nice simple bead along the edge to seal this. It comes out white, but it will dry clear. And it's just enough that there's no holes. I'm telling you, if you have a pinhole, if your thing ain't level, this is a leveling agent that we're using, this EnviroTech, and it is going to run. So make sure it's level first, and make sure that there's nowhere for it to run off. Okay, the EnviroTech is a two-part combination of resiner and hardener. I marked a line on each, and I filled this plastic container with the equal amount of resin and hardener. Follow the directions, it's really simple. But you gotta be prepared for this. You only have 2 minutes. Once you pour these two together, you stir it good, just keep stirring. Stir, stir, stir for 2 minutes. Don't worry about the bubbles, a lot of those will come out when you pour it. Once you got it stirred so well, then you could pour it on. Okay, one thing I did was use a long dowel rod. You could use a paintbrush or really anything, popsicle stick, something to make sure you get it all out of the cup and to have it fill in all the spaces with it. Don't use your fingers. Anything that you use, you're probably going to end up throwing it away. So use something old like this dowel rod here. Little goes a long way. Don't make this too thick. It took this, I think, 2 days for it to totally dry. Humidity will play a factor. And here's how it looks when it's finished. It's a nice, calm water look. At this point, you can peel off your retaining wall that you made, and you can have nice, calm water. I wanted to make some waves, so I used the Woodland Scenics water effects. Now, the first thing you want to do is don't be stupid like me. You got to cut the cap off. I was wondering why nothing was coming out. Okay. So I cut the cap off, and now what you want to do is you want to pour this where you want your waves. And this is almost like a silicone caulk also. So it comes out white, but will dry clear, unless you make it really thick and it will still stay somewhat white. Use a paintbrush and just kind of ripple it and make some waves out of it. This is the first time I've ever tried this, but it came out pretty good. So just take your time, have some fun with it. Now I really want to capture the look of the motor from the barge creating some waves behind it. So I put the barge there, and then behind the boat I went a little thicker with the water effects. Once it dried, it was really white, so I kind of toned it down just a little bit with the same green color paint that I used for the waves. And that's how it turned out. I think it looks pretty good. I also did a little bit up around the front too. In one of my other videos, I showed you how to make the barge, but now I'm going to show you how to make the coal load. And real cheap, easy way to do it is what I did. I used foam from my last layout. Look at this. That was actually scenery from my previous layout. So I just took the foam and I cut it to fit. I took the foam out, shaped it the way I wanted it to, and then I painted it with black acrylic paint. And then I went over it with white glue, Elmer's white glue, not diluted, 100% white glue. And then I sprinkled on this black ballast. It's a real thin ballast from Scenic Express. And I made sure I got it all over. And so you don't waste it, I use an old baking pan. And that way, if anything that fell on the excess, I was able to recycle and put it back into the jar. And so here's the finished river, and with the coal load and the retaining wall, the scene is really coming along great. I still got some more work to do, but I like the way it's turning out. Go back and watch some of my older videos, like how to make a river and how to make the barge. There's a lot of great stuff in there. Keep watching my videos, I appreciate it. If you need to get a hold of me, contact me at djstrains@yahoo.com and see my website, djstrains.com. All right, guys, have a great one. Bye-bye.